Okay, so printing this pattern, what we have to do, we have to first execute this one, then you have to 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 execute this one. In this pattern, what we are getting? We are getting the data into the increasing order. Into the increasing order, but what we have to do? We have to start from here. We have to start from here with 4. Okay, then we have to 3, 2, 1, 0 for the same. Now, if I run this loop for I in range of 5, 0, minus 1. Now what will happen? What will happen if I print I? Now what output I will get? I will get 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, perfect. I am getting the appropriate output. Now what if I assign this value into the J loop? Okay, for the same, I am writing the complete code over here. For I in range of 5, 1, minus 1. Now this loop, okay, you can impart over here 0. Okay, this loop. Now, for the J loop, what we have to do for J in range of, okay, range of I and print of asterisk sign and is equal to this one. And here you have to print. Very simple. Now the first iteration, I become 5. Here, this loop will execute for 4 times. 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time. Because 5 mean 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this loop will be executed for 4 times. Now in the next iteration, what will happen? I value become 4. Okay, now here what output, what value will be assigned over here? 4, then it will run for 4 times. Then 3, okay, then 2, okay, then 1, and so on. Now you will get this pattern. If I show the code to you, that will make more sense. Rather than this strategically, I'm showing you the code for the same. That would make more sense. So I'm deleting it. So for the same, 4, okay, 4, I in the range of 5, comma 0, comma minus 1. Now, if I print simply this, okay, now you can observe it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now, but what I have to do? What I have to do? I am supposed to use here one loop for J in range of I. Print of, okay, asterisk sign, comma, and is equal to this one. Okay, and then you have to print this. Now, yeah, spelling mistake for the range. RANG. Okay, now you can observe the scenario. Exactly same output that I am looking for, the reverse pattern. I think Mohammed sir, picture is clear.
Yes, so you know the J.
This one J. Okay, this one. You are talking about this one. Okay. Now this is just like a loop. It's a loop, simple loop. If I write this for I in, for J in range of I. Okay. Now I am printing it. Print of J. Now what will happen? Observe this scenario. I value starting 5. Now here what value assigned? Here 5 value assigned. So how many times this loop will execute? This will happen for 5 times onto the screen. 5 times onto the screen, the meaning of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this would be happen something like this. Now the picture is clear. Now what exactly happening? In the first case, that this 5 asterisk sign are printing. Now I value decreases for 1. Now you are getting 4 as we discuss in. Now we are getting 4. Here the value is 4 and you will get 4, 3, 2, 1 into the decreasing order. Now the picture is clear for everyone. That's great. Okay, perfect. Now the next one is this loop. Okay, this loop that you have to print this the triangle into the asterisks of triangles. Now for the same, here the role of three loops first, then I will move to the two loops. Okay, to understand this concept, first we have to find out the hidden pattern from this entire picture. Okay, if I clearly observe it. Now where I am put spaces, where I am put this hash line, that's mean these are the spaces. I am changing the color of this for make more sense. Okay, I am using the green. Now space, space space and space. Okay, space 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 space, then space, then space, then space, then space, then space. Now when it appear on the screen, you won't get any kind of spaces. This is the first funda. Now if I check this point in the row number one, that's mean I am considering this row number one. Okay, in the row number one, now how many spaces I am getting? 1 2 3 4. Okay, the four spaces. Then how many spaces I am getting into the next row? I am getting only three rows. Okay, this point I am getting four rows, four spaces. This time I am getting three spaces. This time I am getting two spaces. This time I am getting, you know, the one spaces. This time I am getting the zero space. Now if I do 4 minus 0, how many I will get? I will get four. So how many spaces generated over here? Four spaces. If I do 4 minus 1, how many spaces I will get? 3. 4 minus 2, how many? 2. 4 minus 3, how many? 1. 4 minus 4, how many? 0. Now this value, this is the highest value of rows. This is the highest value of rows. Okay, this one is the highest value of row. So for this, if I understand this first loop, that will iterate through rows. Okay, this one is iterate through rows, and there would be one more row which will print these spaces, which will display these spaces or print these spaces. And the third one is task of printing. Okay, third one is task of printing. Third loop is exactly same that what we did into the previous problem. The third loop, you can observe the scenario, the third loop is exactly same, but this time after printing what I am doing, I am printing star, I am printing space. This is the only difference. Okay, rest the things are same for this loop. So how many loops I will use? I will use three loops. Now observe the scenario, how I will achieve this. So I am cleaning this area for writing the code, and I am changing the pen this time. Okay, now the first loop that will be iterated through 4i in range of 5. Okay, now the picture is clear. I value will be 0, I value would be 1, I value would be 2, I value would be 3, I value would be 4, I value, that's it. Okay, now the first picture is clear that for I values, I will get different values, something like this, I 3 to 1. Okay, now if I check this, this is the first iteration, this is the first iteration where I value is 0. So what I have to do? This, okay, this one, what I have to do? 5 minus 0, okay, because this highest value is 5. 5 minus 0, 5. So how many spaces I will get? I will get 5. Okay, I will get 5 space. Now, in the next iteration, if I do it, 5 minus 1, 4. How many spaces I will get? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, into the next iteration, 5 minus 2, how many I will get? 3 spaces. Into the next iteration, 5 minus 4, I will get 2. Okay, into the next iteration, 5 minus 4, you will get 1. 5 minus 5, 0. You will get none spaces. So this funda is clear. This funda is clear that what we have to do, we have to subtract the value of this I from this value. Okay, because this is our n, this one is our n. User can enter any value over here. If I ask from user, please enter any value, let's suppose user enter 10, so here would become the 10. Okay, this one is n. Okay, I'm taking something like this, I'm making it more dynamic. This one is this time the n. Okay, so n means, just imagine the value, I am taking 10. N means it will take 10. 10 mean 10 minus, okay, 10 minus, 10 minus starting value would be 0. Then how many spaces I will get? I will get 10 spaces. Then 10 minus 1, how many spaces I will get? I will get 4 spaces. Then, 9 spaces. Okay, 10 minus 2, then how many spaces I will get? I will get 8, and so on. So this is the little dynamic your generalized code. Okay, here the user will enter any value. User can enter any value. You can ask from the user what value that you want to add. Let's suppose the user enter 100, then this would be a pair for the 100 rows. Basically these 100 rows. So this is the value for the rows. Now I am writing the complete code for the same. For the same. Now I think the logic part is clear for everyone. Please do let me know if the logic is not clear. Mohammed sir and Ajay sir. And what about Mohammed sir? Okay, perfect. Now I'm writing the complete code for the same. I'm asking from user n is equal to int of, okay, input of enter any value. User can enter any value this time. Okay, I'm writing this roughly. User can enter any value. That you have to think the generalized solution for the same. Now the first iteration for i in range of n, here the value is n. Now whatever value the user entered, that I have to design on that particular point. Okay, if the user enter 100, that's mean there would be 100 spaces, and then asterisk sign will be printed. So into the next iteration. Now my first task is complete, that I will iterate the 100 times, or I will iterate the 5 time, or I will iterate the 10 time, that depend upon this n value. Now it will iterate something like this. Now my first picture is clear, because this loop is for this one. Okay, always keep this point into the mind. Now the next is I am taking care of this spaces for this point of time. For now this time I am using S. You can take any name, you can even take J, don't worry about it. I am specifying with this S because the picture will make more clear. For s in S means spaces. Okay, for S in, okay, now can you tell me, now you can tell me S in range of what here, what would be here, any suggestion from no from your side, sir, Ajay sir or Mohammed sir, please, can you please any Mohammed sir, what do you say here, Mohammed sir, are you there? Oh, do response, hurry up, that I need, I am giving one chance, I am giving both of you, you both of are wrong this time, one take one more chance, then what I have to do, 5 minus 0, 5 minus 1, 5 minus 2, 5 minus 3, 5 minus 4, this value, that is we are iterating, and this value, I am giving you the hint, this value is for I starting value 0, I starting value 1, I starting value 2, I starting value 3, I starting value 4, and up to whatever value that you assign. So I am taking you one more chance, please hurry up, Ajay sir, just tell me, what would be here, Mohammed sir, now your turn, just take one more chance. Ajay sir, I didn't get second answer from your side. N minus 5, okay, you are saying N minus 5, okay, the N value, let's suppose 5, okay, and you are saying N minus 5, then what would happen, 5 minus 5, 0, how many spaces would be happen over here, 0, into the next iteration, what would be happen, now in the next iteration, the I value become 1, okay, now 1 minus 5, that would be minus 4, and this is valid? No, this is not valid. Yes, here would be the n minus i, okay, so delete it, okay, so understand this n minus i, okay, n minus i. Now number n is anything, what i value starting, the I value starting 0. Now 5 minus 0, now how many times this would be happen for 0 to 4, that's mean 5 times, then what you have to do over here, print space, okay, space, and you need consecutive spaces. For consecutive spaces, what you have to do, you have to simply use this. Okay, now the rest, now this task is done, the spaces concept is done, your cursor is blinking over here. Now how many times that you have to print only once, you have to print only once. For printing only once, what you have to do, you have to for k in, or you can use j in range of. Now please tell me what would be here. Now you guys will tell me, Ajay sir, what would be here this time? I, perfect. Okay, now your output would be appear on the screen. Okay, let me show, that would be make more sense. Now understand this case. Okay, now I'm taking the static value of n, that is, let's support 10. This time 10 I'm taking. For I in range of n, I'm passing over here n. Okay, for j in, for space in, for s in, because I am taking spaces s, for s in range of, okay, that is n minus I. Perfect. Now what you have to do, consecutive spaces, for consecutive spaces that you have to simply do and is equal to this one. Okay, that would be the consecutive spaces. Now into next, for j in range of, okay, for j in range of, that what you have to do, the very simple I, and then you have to print asterisk sign. Okay, you have to print asterisk sign and you have to do end is equal to again this one. Okay, after printing asterisk sign, I need space. Okay, so I am giving space. You can giving over here space. If you don't want to give over here, then you can give the space over here. Choice is again your. Okay, now then you have to print. Now a beautiful pattern. Okay, range spelling every time mistake. Now a beautiful pattern would be appear, range. Okay, now the beautiful pattern will be appear on the screen. Now you can observe, this is work for 10, this is work for 10, because I am using n is equal to 10. Now you can observe 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Why 8? Because if I do this, okay, so let me, because in the first iteration the I value becomes 0 over here, so this is not executed. If I plus 1 over here, now you can observe that would be 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, total 10 iteration. Okay, choice is again your pattern would be there, but this time the printing start from, as we already discussed into the last video, the printing start from 00. Okay, in the previous example, here it's counting 1. In 00, in 00 there would be nothing, because what I am doing, for I in range of 0, the range of 0 doesn't make any sense. Okay, for 0 plus 1 makes sense, 0 plus 1 makes sense, that it will run for 0th iteration. So I think the picture is clear for everyone. And this one is okay, perfect. And what about Muhammad sir? Okay, that's great. Now I achieve this thing with three loop, the same thing that I can be achieved with two loops only. So understand this point, as we already discussed this thing, if I do this 5, okay, into 5, then how many spaces would be appear? I think we know this pattern, we already discussed inside this Python, we discussed earlier, or note this one. If I do this hello multiply by 2, then what output I will get? I will get hello. Yes, perfect. That's mean I discussed this thing earlier in this session. Yes, anyone having doubt regarding this? Because I am using the concept of this one to achieving this thing with two loops. Anyone having? No, perfect. Okay. Now observe this thing. I am achieving same thing with two for loops this time. For the same what we have to do, for I in range of, that's mean I am taking 5. Okay, now this time print, I am directly use over here print, okay, this space multiply by 5 minus I. Okay, and I need consecutive spaces and is equal to this one. Now you can observe this scenario, what would be happen over here if I run this thing. What would be happen? It will print the consecutive 5 spaces. So I value starting 0, I am using 5 minus 0. That's mean 5, this step, this become this one, 5. So what is the mean of this? the meaning of this one is it would appear 5 spaces. Okay, then I value become 1, 5 minus 1, how many spaces would be appear? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 minus 2, okay, then it would 3, and then it would 2, and it would 1. Okay, the same thing can be happen with this kind of scenario. Now, the next task is over there. After consecutive spaces, your cursor is blinking over here. And what you have to do over here? You have to print over here a 1 star. Okay, now into the second iteration, when I value become 2, how many time it will execute? 2 times. When I value become 3, how many time it will execute? It will execute 3 times. Now into the next iteration, when I value become 4, how many time it will be executed? 4 times. For printing the same thing, the exactly the previous loop that I am using for j in range of I, and then you have to do print of asterisk sign and is equal to space, okay, and is equal to space, and what you have to do, you have to print n. This is the exactly same, the output would be same, but this time I'm using this for loop only. I will show you the code, then the picture is more clear. Okay, so this time I'm using half of code, this one, to save the time. Okay, for this time, for removing this loop, I am removing this loop. Okay, I remove this loop. Then here what I have to do, just print space multiply by now n minus I. Okay, n minus I, and I need consecutive. For consecutive I have to use this one. Perfectly good one. Now you can check the output is same, exactly same, but we achieve with how many loops? I achieved only with 2 loops. Okay, now one more pattern I am going to generate via this. Very simple. At this time I am removing these spaces. Now you can check it out. Your further assignment is completed. I think the assignment number 3. Your assignment number 3 has been done. The next assignment, what you have to do? You have to just simply, rather than to print this asterisk sign, what you have to print? You have to print I value, and you can observe your further assignment is completed. Okay, one more assignment on this for this one J. Okay, for this one J, and your one more assignment is completed. So only changes of one character, I am getting the different pattern. Okay, rather than to printing the star over here, what I am printing the value of I. In the first time when it execute, then the I value is 0. In the next time then it execute, I value is 1, and it run for 2 times, 1 and 1, then I value 2 only. Okay, if I clearly observe it, this value, this one, I already told you we are iterating I for rows only, and this one is the zeroth row, and this one is the one row, and how many time it is executing in this case? If I understand this point, this zeroth executing only for one time. Okay, then on the one row how many time printing is done? The 2 times. I am getting 2 times of 1, but rather than printing star, I am printing the value of the row, on which row that it is standing. On this row it is standing, into this. Okay, into the next one, rather than printing the value of I, I am just printing the value of J. Okay, in the jth, in the zeroth iteration, I use 0 plus 1, that's mean J would be execute for only 1 time, that would be only for 0 time. Okay, so output would be 0. In the next iteration, it will execute for 2 times, for 0 and for 1. In the next iteration, it would be executed for 2 times, for 0, 1 and 2. Into the next iteration, it would be executed for 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Why? Changing only a single character, I am getting the different patterns. This is the way to generate the, the scenario, something like this. So anyone having doubt, please let me know. Mohammed sir? Mohammed sir?
sir? Are you there? What happened to Mama, sir? So, clear the concept or not? Minus n. Okay, now. Yes. Okay, that's great. Very good. Okay, for the same thing, I can achieve with the one line of code. Okay, for the same thing that I can achieve with the one line of code. Now observe the code, how I can achieve it. N is equal to, let's suppose I'm using n is equal to 5. Okay, for the same, for printing the pattern, for I in range of n, okay, for I in the range of n. Now this time, what we have to do, simply you have to print your space, okay, your space multiply, the same scenario, multiply by n minus I, okay, n minus I, the same thing that you have to do. And after that, what, okay, if I do this, now there is nothing. If I do this, now you can observe which pattern is generating. Okay, I am using this. Now you can observe which pattern is generating. Okay, this pattern is generated. Now you can observe. Okay, this pattern is generated with the single line of code. Same thing, I am printing the spaces. Okay, firstly I am printing the spaces n minus I, and then what you have to print, I am concatenating, okay, and this asterisk sign, okay, this asterisk sign, and I am multiplying it with j. Now you can check which pattern is ready. The pattern that ready is something wrong. So here j, sorry, I did a mistake, I use this j. Okay, now you can check it out, which pattern is ready. This pattern is ready. Why so? Because we didn't use this. Now you can observe this scenario. Now you can observe what exactly happening over here. First time I use space, okay, space multiply by I starting value 0, then n value is 5 or 6, whatever value that we assign. Okay, this one. Okay, now observe. Plus I am concatenating this asterisk sign and space and multiply by I. Okay, the first time what would be happen into the first time, observe this. First time the space, okay, multiply by 6 minus 0 6, okay, this would be happen. That's mean you get 1 2 3 4 5 6 spaces. Okay, now this is 0, that's mean it wouldn't be happen. Okay, it wouldn't be happen. Now the cursor move to the, it doesn't print anything over here. Okay, it doesn't print anything over here. If you want to print over here, then what you have to do, you have to use I plus 1, then it will print over here. Okay, it doesn't make any sense, na? If I do it, asterisk sign multiply by 0, what sense it make? That's mean 0, nothing, you have to do nothing. Okay, into next iteration, I value become 1. So 6 minus 1, how many spaces that you will get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and this time, I value is, I am not using this plus, I value is 1. So this multiply by 1, how many asterisk over here? 1 asterisk over here. Okay, now into next iteration, 6 minus 2, how many spaces I will get? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and this time, the I value become 2, how many asterisk signs I will get? 1 and 2. And I am placing over here space, that this one, okay, this one. Now I think the picture is clear. This one is very easy way to do the same thing. We perform the same triangle with the 3, that is the traditional way. If you use C++, then you have to use this kind of pattern, but you are using Python. Okay, this time that you are using two loops, that is again Pythonic. This is called Pythonic way. Again I use this one loop. Okay, this is the more Pythonic way. Now choice is again your, but you have to start from here. Okay, you have to start from here. You can move to this, you can move to this, but in the production 90% this three loop or two loop will be mostly used. Okay, at that time the one loop will not fulfill your all the requirements. Okay, that we discuss into the, you know, the last video. This one you have to represent the data into the rows and columns. For this time, this one loop I would not say it will work fine, so you have to take the help of two loops or you have to move to the three loops. Picture is clear or not? Anything, anyone? So this is the way. I show you all the ways how we can achieve the same output with the traditional way, with, you know, with Pythonic way and with more Pythonic way. Okay, this you won't get on YouTube. This way you will get this way, you will get this way, but three loops with two loops, very rare chance that you will get two loop. I can guarantee you will never find on YouTube. I can bet you with the help of two loops, very difficult to find on the YouTube. So move further. Now I hope you guys will perform this. I hope you guys will perform this, and 100% I know you guys will do it. Okay, with the three loops, and you can do the same thing with two loops. Again, you can do the same loop with one loop, the same thing with one loop. Choice is again your reverse. No, I am not covering this assignment. Okay, so the next assignment was this one, 1 1. Okay, 1 2 1. For this I am not waste time, because I give the clear cut explanation, in-depth explanation on my US data technology channel. Okay, you can follow that channel to understand the concept. I elaborate each and everything in great detail over there. I express the, you know, the complete mathematics behind this, and you just enjoy the code over here. You can check out the code from there, and you can understand the logic, what exactly logic behind this. So I will not, you know, solve this problem into this session. So if you have any problem after watching my video, then come back to me. I will solve this particular, you know, the pattern into the live video. So next one, the important one, that what was that assignment? Okay, you have to generate prime numbers between 10 to 100. Okay, that was our assignment, and after that you have to print them into the appropriate format. For printing into the, let's suppose I am using this format, I will use this format to printing the data into this format. The same logic that we developed into the last video, that would be helpful for us. But this time, presenting these stars, what we are doing, we are performing the, you know, the concept of this one. We are performing the concept of this one, rather than to printing the star, that you are supposed to print the prime numbers. And we know how to find the prime numbers, but the question is, this time you have to find the prime number between 10 to 100. That is the question. Now understand this concept, very important one again, and very easy, because we already studied the prime number and how we can find out the prime numbers. So I am asking from user, okay, enter two values. I am asking from user, please enter two values. Please enter two values. The user enter 10, the first value, the upper value user enter, let's suppose I am taking very small value, 20. Now the question is, we have to find out the prime numbers from 10 to 20. By the way, anyone solve this assignment or not? Anyone solve this assignment or not? Okay, no problem. So the first question is that we have to find out the prime numbers from 10 to 20. 10 to 20, I am saying we have to run from 10 to 20 immediately. Picture came into the mind. What picture came into the mind, that what loop that you have to use? Yeah, perfect, that we have to use for loop. The for loop pattern would be something like this: for I in, yes, 10 to 21, perfect, very good, 10 to 21. Why I use 21? Because we know always n minus 1, that we have to check this 20 as well. Okay, so this first concept is clear, very good. Now how I value become, what I value become? 10, then I value become 11, I value become 12, I value become 13, I value become 14, I value become 14, and up to 20. So if I want to check this number, is this number is prime or not? What is the logic behind this? Okay, I want to check the 10 number is prime or not. Then what we have to do? We have to, yes, we have to check this number from 2 to 9. Okay, I am once again saying, sir, 2 to 9, that means we have to run from 2 to 9, the number minus 1. Sir, for this kind of scenario, again I think we have to use one more for loop. Perfect, you have to take the help of the second for loop, that would be the inner for loop. Okay, now into the next iteration, when I will become 11, then what would happen? That 11, okay, we have to check this number is prime or not. We have to run the iteration 2 to 10. Okay, sir, now we will find out this number is prime or not. Again, in when we get 12, this I value become 12, then we have to run this iteration 2 to again 11. 13, then we have to check 3 to again 12, and so on. Now you can understand this scenario. This value is changing. Okay, this value is changing. This value is also changing. For this iteration, if I say these are the rows 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and up to 20. Okay, and for this row, okay, from we have to start a loop from 2. This is the constant value that we are all, sorry, this one again 2. We are always starting a, you know, from 2 to 9. Okay, this time we are checking this number 2 to 10. Okay, for this time we are checking number 2 to 11. For this time we are checking number 2 to 12. For this time we are checking number 2 to 13. Now you can check it out what is happening inside this loop. This loop will be start from 2 and the end would be i, because by default our loop is always n minus 1. If this I value 10, if 10 value over here, then what would be happen? 2 to 9. Okay, if 11 value would be here, what would be happen? 2 to 10. If 12 value would be here, what would be happen? 2 to 11. That's it. That's mean the second loop, the starting is constant for everyone. Every time that we are starting from 2. But we are running this loop that depend on the value of this I. So we have to pass into the second loop for I, j in range of 2 to I. Now observe the code. Very simple. Sir, if I give you 7, how you will define it? This number is prime or not? For that we have 2, we have to check it 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and then you are deciding. No, we are not checking before 10. This is our main number that we have to check. Okay, if I give you, let's understand this scenario. I have 10 numbers, 10, 11, 12, and 13. I give you first number 10 and I am saying you, okay, please tell me this number is prime or not. You will do your own mathematical? You will do your own calculations? You will do or not? Definitely. Sir, that is for the even or odd. You are confusing it. That is for even or odd. 10 modulation double equals to 2. What is the meaning of this? That you are checking the number is even or not. But this time that we are checking the number is prime or not. Just think like this. If anyone having any doubt, just think like it. I give you this number. Okay, I have series of number 2, 5, 2, 36. Okay. And up to, let's suppose, 240. If you guys have any doubt, I have these numbers and you are my logic. Okay, so I got a task from project manager. These are the number that you have to check. This number is prime or not. Okay, you guys are my logic. I have to run from 235 to 240. Okay, that's five times that I have to do the iteration. Now I am giving you this number. Okay, I am giving you this number. Okay, you return me something. Okay, your logic is say, sir, you have to run from 2 to 34. Okay, now understand the optimization technique. We have to again use break. And why we are using break? Because in the first iteration, I came to know this is not a prime number. Then why should I waste my resource with 3? Why should I waste my resource with 4, 5, 6, 7 and up to 233? Okay, so this is the way. Now observe the code for the same. For same what I am doing. For I in range of L to upper plus 1. Okay, upper plus 1, let's suppose the lower limit is 10, the upper limit is 20. So I am running the first loop, that would be from 10 to 21. Okay, so this time, now it's my logic. Now the second loop, 4, this loop will give you the numbers, it will assign the numbers. Okay, 4, now 4, J, A. Sir, I have to check 20 also. No, but I am asking from user. No? This time I am making some generalized logic. I am asking. Yeah, you can do some. Yes, you can use something like this. You have to ask this number from user, and I am giving you one more assignment into this. Okay, so this time, what you have to do for J in range of. Now this loop will be executed from in the first iteration when I value is 10. This loop will be executed from 2 to 9. For the same, what you have to do? I, 2, 2, I. Okay, now this will become 2 to 10. And how many time it will run? Always n minus 1, that we know it very well. So it will execute from 2 to 9. In 2 to 9, what we have to do? If this value I contain 10, that you have to check this I modulation of j double equals to 0. Okay, this mean if this condition is satisfied, what is the meaning of this? This cannot never be a prime number. It cannot be never a prime number. So for the same, I am breaking this loop. When my system enter into this condition, that's mean immediately I have to break. The breaking mean I am breaking this loop. Okay, because this break is concerned with this loop, not with this loop. Okay, this break is concerned with this loop. When my program enter into the this condition, I have to break this loop. And when this loop is breaked, when this loop is not successfully run, what is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is that I number is not a prime number. Okay, and this time I am using this else. And this else is specified with this for loop. And when else will be executed? We know it very well. When this loop will be executed successfully. On which criteria this loop will be executed successfully? When the number is prime. When the number is prime, it wouldn't be enter into the this condition. When it is not enter into the this condition, that's mean our for loop runs successfully. And when this for loop runs successfully, I am using else with this for, and this would be executed. And I am printing this I. Very simple code. Now I think the picture is clear. Okay, let me show you the code. Yes, we use both of the ways. You can again use here C is equal to 0. You can use as well. But this time I am using some Pythonic way, because we already know this for loop. I discussed this thing into the last class, that we can also use this for loop with else. If you guys remember or not, I think you guys forgot about it. Okay, so now I am writing the code for the same. Okay, I am taking lower limit, that is 10. Okay, and this time upper limit, that is 20. For this, what I am doing? For I in range of L comma upper plus 1. Okay, upper plus 1, as we know it very well. For J in range of 2 comma I. Okay, 2 comma I. 2 comma I. And what we have to do? If I modulation of J double equals to 0, then simply B R E A K break. Okay, otherwise else what you have to do, print of I. Now you can check it out. There are only 4 prime numbers which are associated between 10 to 20. There are only 4 prime numbers. Now this is the first funda.
Nay, you are saying I modulation of 2 double equals to 0. You are specifically focus on 2. But I am, if you carefully observe it, this j value is changing. In the first iteration, the j value is 2. In the next iteration, j value is 3, 4, 5, 6, and up to number minus 1. Yes, I is 10, and j becomes j will execute. J will execute for first time. The first time, let's suppose I am taking 7. Okay, for make the concept clear. For the first time I am taking 7, that's mean I become 7. Or what we can do, we just make it more simple. I am taking 11, okay? I am taking this 11, okay? So I value is 11. In the second iteration, I value become 11. Now it enter into this loop. And this loop says that I have to execute. I value is 11, that's mean I have to run from 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 10, okay? Now, in first iteration, when j value 2, in the first iteration j value 2, it enter into this condition, okay, 11 modulation of j double equals to 0, it says no. Okay, now j value become 3, 11 modulation of 3 not, okay, and then 4 not, then 5 not, then 9 not, then 10 not. Now this condition successfully executed. When this condition successfully executed, the meaning of that is this number never divide with any of these numbers. Perfectly never divide with any of these numbers. When this number doesn't divide, when we didn't get this condition, that's mean this number is a prime number. And what we have to print? We have to print this I. Why it will execute? Because this condition runs successfully. This is the case number 1. Now I am taking the case number 2. This time I value that I am taking 10, okay, I value is 10, then this loop says that you have to run from 2 to 9, okay, 2 to 9. In this way, what will happen? I modulation of j starting value 2, j starting value 2 double equals to 0, yes, perfectly, it divide perfectly. When it divide perfectly, then what will happen? It run the break. And what is the meaning of break? Break mean it immediately stop this iteration, this for loop. It immediately stop this for loop. And when this for loop is break down, then this for loop break down, this else would never be execute. So this is the funda. I think the picture is clear or not. Okay, you are confusing on over here. Okay, so just take Muhammad one thing. Understand this thing layman term, in layman term that we are understanding it. Okay, for understanding this thing, you will only involve. Nobody else will give the answer. Ajay sir, clear the concept or not? Or should I involve you? Okay, perfect. And what about yours, Vishal sir? Okay. Perfect. Now, Muhammad sir, kindly concentrate on my point. I have these numbers, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I am taking only these numbers. Okay, I have these numbers. Now, I am giving you 10. Please tell me, this is the prime or not? This is prime or not? Yes, that's the question. I know this is the point, because you don't know. We discuss it into the last, you know, the last lecture in great detail, how we can find out the prime number. So anyways, now I am explaining this thing once again. How I can check the number is prime or not? This is the question. So I am taking now, what are the prime number? First of all, that the numbers which are
which are divided by you know itself, okay, or one, okay, the number which are divided by itself or one, that number would be considered as a prime number. Now the picture is clear. Divided by itself, no, yeah, that's why we were skipping it, no, that's why we are skipping it. We are writing our loop. Now understand it. Now from where we are starting our loop. We are starting our loop from 2. If the number is 10, we are checking it. We are checking it from 2 to 9. 2 to 9. I am considering 2 to 9. I am not considering 1. Here you can observe the scenario over here. I start my loop from 2. I am not considering 1. If I consider over here 1, then what will happen? This condition will be true for everyone. But I am start checking with 2. Okay, now take it again the layman term. I am giving you this number. I am giving you 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I am giving you this number. How would you check it? How would you make your final conclusion? This number is prime or not? You will start dividing it from 2. And you will check, okay, it is perfectly divided or not? No, you will say no, I didn't get 0. Okay, in the next iteration, you will check with 3. Yes, if it is equal to 0, if it is equal to 0, then what is the meaning of that? Yes, that's no, then it is not prime. Now observe this scenario. Okay, 10 10 2 5 10, okay, I am getting 0. That's mean when I get this 0, this is the modulus. When I get this 0, that's mean it's not a prime number. Okay, it's not a prime number. It is not a prime because I got this 0. But in the case of 11, you can check it out. 2, okay, firstly we have to check with 2. Okay, 2 5 the 10. Okay, now I am getting 1. Okay, perfect. That's mean I am not getting 0. And again I have to check with 11. 3 3 the 9. Okay, I am getting 2. Okay, no. Okay, and in case of 4, 4 to the 8, I am getting 3. Okay, 4, and next is the 5 1 the 5, and I am getting 6. Okay, no, I didn't get 0. Again I will go with 6. Okay, 6 1 the 6, and I am getting 5. Okay, perfect. No, 7 7 1 the 7. Okay, I am getting, you know, 4 this time. Okay, no, I didn't get 0. Okay, next time 8 8 8 1 the 8. Okay, 3, I didn't get 0. 9, the next is 9 11 9 1 the 9. Okay, I am getting 2. I am getting 2 again. I didn't get 0. Okay, this time 10 11. Okay, I am getting 1. Now you can check it out. In any of the case, did you get 0? Did you get anywhere 0? Here no, here no, here no, here no, 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 no. Then what observation? What observation? If I do this 11, 11. Now this time 0. So I have not checked. I haven't checked with it. Okay. So in any of the case, I didn't get 0. When I didn't get 0, then I decide finally, sir, this is prime number. The same thing when I do with 12. Okay, the 11 I declared it's prime. Now I am giving you the next number, that is 12. Okay, now I am giving you the next number, that is 12, and you start the same process. 2 6 the 12. Now this time you get 0. Now you immediately say, sir, this is not a prime number, no need to check with 3. Why I go with 3? Because I got the 0 into the first iteration. Sir, I don't waste my time. Now you will say, break, sir, break. I got 0. That's mean it will never be a prime number. If I check with 3, no need. Check with 4, no need. Check with 5, no need. Because in the first iteration that I got 5. Okay, in the case of 13, what will happen? The same entire process happens up to 2 to 12. In any of the cases, you won't get 0. and you finally decide, sir, 13 is a prime number. In the case of 14, now understand, in the case of 14, when you divide by 2, okay, 2, 7, 14, you are getting 0. Sir, this couldn't be prime number. Break over here. Break your steps over here. No need to proceed further. No need to check with 3. No need to check with 4. Okay, in the case of 15, now you take, I'm taking last case. In the case of 15, what is happening? 2, 7, the 14. Okay, this time you are getting 1. No problem. Okay, and then you have to check with 3. You have to check with 3. 3, 5, the 15. Now you are getting 0 and you are taking final decision. You are taking final decision. Sir, I got 0. Break over here. No need to proceed further. So this is the same concept. This is the same concept that I am using over here. This loop is saying me, okay, you get 10. Now this loop is says, okay, now I have to execute from 2 to 9. And I have to do these steps, exactly that we did. We have to perform these steps. Okay, whenever you got zero, immediately break this chain. No need to proceed further. When I break the chain, that's mean this else would not be executed. Why so? Because this is the part of this for. And when this condition is not run successfully, I explicitly break it. When this breaked out, that's mean this else would not execute. So this is the picture. I think the picture is clear or not, Muhammad? Sorry, I didn't get. Go back. Yes. I'm saying it 10 to 20 because I'm making this generalized code that you have to ask from user. Okay, user say, okay, the lower value is 500 and upper value is 900. So what 900? Okay, so what you have to do? You have to run this loop from 500 to 900, that you need the prime number between these two numbers. Yes. Two is basically the concept. Yes, concept is same, that first iteration the number will be executed from, when I value become 500, then the number will execute 499. In the third time, when the number is 501, it will execute from 2 to 500. Then it will execute into next iteration, then it will execute from 5 to 501 and then 502 and so on. Because I value is increasing. That first time I have 500, I am giving you the 500. You are checking, you are implementing this logic. The logic is same. The logic won't change. The number, whatever number you can take, even you can take 50,000 and n number, infinity number. Okay, the logic would be same. But make sure, now what you have to do else into this, but make sure. This number will be lower. If this number is a lower than this number, then this condition will be executed. Let's suppose the lower number I enter 500, the upper number I enter 20, then it wouldn't be happen. So you have to take care about this condition. You have to check, you have to use this clause. If you know the upper is greater than lower, then you have to implement all these things. Else you have to simply print say your upper is lesser than the lower. Okay, so you have to print this message. You have to impart the entire code inside this if. Okay, this is your assignment, that you have to check this condition. If this condition doesn't satisfy, satisfied, then it had to implement. If it is doesn't satisfied, then you have to implement this one. I think the picture is clear. Okay, now the next task is that you have to print the number into this pattern. So append, I think we already discussed append mean. So I am using this L and I am appending. I am appending into this list. Okay, so now observe this scenario. What I am doing, rather than printing, I am inserting the all prime numbers into a list. Okay, for the same I am using ll is equal to this one. Okay, I am using this ll is equal to this one, that is my empty list. For this, now the same code here, what I am doing, rather than printing, I am appending it. LL dot append of I. Very simple. Okay. Now if you check it out, this LL contain the prime numbers. Okay, these are the prime number between 10 to 100 with the help of append. Append mean we know very well, add the data into the end. First it entered this, after that it entered this, after that it entered this, after that it entered this. Okay, so now the question is that we have to print this into the specific pattern. So we know len method. So len of this one is 4. Okay, the length of this one is 4. For the same what I am doing, for I in range of len of LL. Okay, so it will execute from 0 to 3. Okay, 0 to 3. Now the same for j in range of I plus 1. Okay, so we know this. For the same, now next print. Now this time print LL of, you can use I or you can use j. Now end is equal to this one, because what I am doing over here, rather than printing the asterisk sign, I am using the slicing of this list. The i value 0, how many times this loop will execute? In the first iteration it will execute only for 1, so 11 would be appeared on the screen. In the next iteration the i value become 1, so this data would be fetched out. And how many times this loop will execute? 2 times, then you will get 13. Okay, now check the output, the picture would be more clear. The same code that we used. Okay, now observe the scenario. I am changing this time over here, I am printing j. So it is doing the slicing according to the j value. So now you can check the pattern is little different. 11 11 13 11 13 17 11 13 17 11 13 13 17 17 19. The choice is again your, what you want to do. I will not explain this point this time. If you don't understand it, try by your own. So that would make more clarity, because we already print that asterisk sign, we already print this asterisk sign n number of times. Okay, so rather than to print this asterisk sign, now this time I am printing the list value, I am printing the list data into this format. So you guys are supposed to perform this, okay, by your own. Don't take help of this video. Okay, so I am rubbing it. Okay, so I am closing it, I am not showing anymore. So you have to do by your own. I give you just like a hint that what you have to do. Okay, the picture is clear or not? Anyone having doubt till now, please do let me know. Yes, do practice. That's why I am closing this screen. This is simple one. Rather than to printing the asterisk sign, I am just implementing very, you know, the little logic. Yes, I am implementing very little logic, and now you guys can, you know, better understand why we are printing that star pattern, why we are working on that star patterns. This example, you know, clear the picture. So the next one, and get ready for your assignment. Tomorrow is Sunday. Okay, so Sunday, as we know, the holiday, and for me it's only holiday, and for you it's a assignment day. So so the next topic, mama sir, everything fine? Mama sir, get ready for the further assignments, and I hope this time you will submit all the assignments to me. So anyways, now understand the next concept. Now this time we learn for in great detail, we learn this for nested for in great detail. We know these two things, okay, and we make more than, you know, the including my problems that I, you know, give you the example. Approximately we cover, I suppose, with if, with for, and with this for, 15 to 20, and might be it would be more than 20 problem that we sorted out till now. Okay, so I think, yes, this much amount of problem that we already solved with this for, you know, with the nested for and with the if. Now the next task is your, the next iteration, that is the while. Okay, this one is the while, exactly same as a for loop. No need, you know, learned about more this. When I give you one example, you will automatically understand what exactly role of this. Now, the two loops, the four, the same thing that you can do with the four, the same thing you can do with the while. choice is again your. Choice is again your. Whatever you want to use, you can use. Even all patterns can be generated with this while loop. All patterns. Okay. Whatever we made with this for loop, the exactly every problem, whatever problem that we solve with for and nested for, the exactly every problem can easily solve with this while. Now understand this while. The while. What is the meaning of the while in the general language? In some extent. Okay. While. You have to work while the time is not, you know, 6 or 7. Whatever, you know, the general sentence you can make with the help of this while. So exactly same over here. You have to work while. Okay. There would be some kind of condition. The condition is up to 7. Okay, whatever condition that you are specifying over here, you can specify it. So now understand the while concept. In computer science, how I can use this while? Very simple. I is equal to 0. The initialization, this concept is called initialization. There we use simply this for I in range of this. Okay, there is no need for initialization, but this time we need an initialization for the same. And while, okay, while, what while? And I have to specify the condition over here. And what condition that you want to say? Okay, I am saying while I value less than 10. Okay, I value less than 10. What I have to do? You have to print I. Okay, you have to print this I. Now, for terminating this condition, when this condition will be terminated? When I becomes 11. Or I become 10. At that point of time, when I become 10, okay, then this condition will be breakdown. Okay, for breaking this condition, what I have to use? I is equal to I plus 1. Now understand this concept. Now while, we know the general meaning of the while in English. Okay, now while we have to perform this. On what condition that we have to perform this? Until this value is less than 10. Okay, I am saying less than 10. So now I value starting 0, the first iteration, I less than 10, condition is true, condition is perfectly true. Now what you have to print I. Now on the screen, what output you will get? 0. In the next line, what is happening? I plus equals to 1. Now I value become 1, mean 0 plus 1 1. I value become 1. Now 1 less than 10, yes, condition true. Now I value 1, print it on screen. Now I is equal to I plus 1, okay, 1 plus 1, that's mean 2. Okay, now 2 less than 10, perfect, condition is true. 3, yes. 4, yes. 5, yes. 6, yes. 9, 8, yes. 7, yes. 9, yes. Yes, it will run up to 9, because 9 less than 10. Now after executing this 9, now what value will be become I will become 10. Okay, I will become 10. And this time 10 less than 10, no, this time this is false. When this is false, then this process will be stopped. Okay, because this entire process, whatever logic I want to implement, that is depend upon this condition. And how I can increase? We have to use over here increment, or you can increase decrement. Let's suppose you want to generate something like this. No, 10, 9, 7, 8, you know, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. For the same, what you have to do? Very simple. You have to starting value I 10. Okay, while this time I greater than 0. Now I am reversing it. I greater than 0. Okay. Now this 10 greater than 0, yes, condition true. Then what you have to do? You have to print I. Now what printing on the screen? 10 would be printed. Now for decreasing this value, what you have to do? I is equal to I minus 1. Now I value become 10 minus 1, that I value become 9. Now this time 9 greater than 0, yes, print 9. Then 8, 7, 6, 4, 5, okay, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, now when it becomes zero, now what would happen? 0 greater than 0? No. At that time, this loop is breaked out. So this is very basics about, you know, this while loop. How we can use exactly same the iteration concept, okay, the incrementing concept there. If I use this there, the incrementing, okay, incrementing automatically, whether you assign or not, it automatically considers something like this, the stepping. Basically this is the stepping, okay, the step of incrementing. Okay, here you want to take the step of 2, you want to take the step of 2, very simple, plus 2. Okay, you want to take the step of 4, very simple, let's take the step of 4. Here we can implement stepping something like this. This is the equivalent to the stepping. Okay, equivalent to the stepping. By default the positive stepping, okay, but explicitly that you want to run the negative stepping, that you have to tell in the same scenario over here. If you want to run the negative stepping, that you have to explicitly tell 10, 0, -1, that you have to tell. Otherwise it will take the plus 1 over here. Now keep this point into the mind. I am giving you some very simple example of this. Now understand it. No, there is, but yes, we can use else. I will later on teach you. Okay, we can use else with 4. You can use the break as well, but I have to break on some, you know, on my breaking is done on some condition. My breaking is done on some, yes. If I do break over here, if I do break over here, I can use break over here. Then what would be happen? It will run only for one time. It will just print this 10, and after that it will be breakout. But I want to this entire scenario. For getting the entire scenario, that I am implementing this logic. If I implement break over here, then what will happen? It will run only one, and then it will implement break. Break mean stop the iteration. When this condition become false, because this while, the general meaning of the while is you have to perform this while, okay, on basis of some condition, that you have to work while your boss is not coming, something like this you can consider it. When your boss is coming, then you are supposed to go home, something like this. Okay, now understand it, how we can achieve it. Let's suppose I is equal to 0 while I less than 10. Okay, I less than 10, print of I, and you can check I plus equals to 1. Okay, now you can check it out. Now it's running from 0 to 9. If I show the value of I, now you can observe I value become 10, and then 10 less than 10 condition is false, and this loop is breakdown. Okay, for the this one, let's suppose now I am assigning I is equal to 10. Okay, for this time while I greater than 0. Okay, while I greater than 0, print of I is equal to I minus 1. Now you can check the output. Now that this time is output is little different. You can check it out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so this is the scenario. You can use for, you can use while. Choice is again your. You want minus 0. You want minus 0. Okay, now you will get minus 0. Okay, you have to perform over here minus 1. Okay, so I think the picture is clear regarding while. Anyone having any question for while, please let me know before proceeding the next, you know, for the assignments basically. Yes, you can perform all the assignment with the help of while. All assignment. Okay, so we are proceeding further. Now this is the assignment for 4. This is the assignment for nested 4. Okay, these are the assignments that you have to perform with the while loop. The first thing that you have to perform the same, this is the refresher, multiplication of a table. The same output I need. The first question that we solve with, you know, with 4, the exactly same that you have to solve with this while. the same that you have to solve with y. This is just a refresher for, you know, for your y. And the second one is convert decimal number to binary, decimal number to octal, decimal number to hexadecimal. Do you know this binary conversion? You guys know this binary conversion or not? This binary conversion. Yes. For that, yes, we use this. For that, we use this 1010. This method that we use. Now we are supposed to create this way. Okay, now we will see the functionality of this when we design the code for this. So binary, as we know, if I do this, okay, let me show you. Okay, if I want to convert this into the binary, then what we have to do? 2, 5, 10. Okay, I will get 0. Next, you will get 5. 2 to the 4, then we will get 1. Okay, this we need. Then 2 to 1. Okay, 2 to 1. We get 0. Okay, 1 divided by 2, then we will get 0. So this is the way. Now you can observe it. The first time it executed, okay, and I got this 0. Now in the second time, I am using this 5. Okay, I am using this 5, and you are getting this 1. Third time, I am using this 2, the quotient, this 2, and I am getting 0. In the next time, okay, I am using this, and I am getting, sorry, I am getting 1. Here 1, sorry, here 1. The quotient is, you know, the quotient is 0 and the remainder is 1. For this, when I divide 2 with 1, okay, the quotient is 0 and the remainder become 1. Okay, so this one is the output that I am getting, but keep this point into the mind. When we represent it into the binary digits, then we have to follow from bottom. So what output I will get? 1010, that I have to follow from the bottom. So how I can represent the binary representation of 10? This is the way. We have to perform this thing until your condition will become, you have to run until you won't get this quotient 0. Okay, you won't get this quotient 0, then you are supposed to perform these steps again, and one day when you divide with 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, and one day you will get the quotient, that this quotient is 0, and when you get this quotient 0, that's mean your task is over. And that time you have to store these values and you have to run from the bottom. Okay, now if I represent this thing, then first the last value which I has received, then I use this, then after this, then after this, and then after this, then you will get 1010. This is the way to represent the binary numbers. Okay, try to solve this assignment. Okay, with the octal, very little change. Where you are using 2, there you have to use 8. Okay, in the hexadecimal, that you have to use the 16. Okay, 4, 16. But keep this point into the mind. When you perform the hexadecimal, 0 to 9, it's perfect. When you will get the remainder 10, then you have to convert it into the A. When you will get 11, you have to convert it into the B. When you get 12, you have to convert into C. 13 for D, 14, you know, for E, 15 for F. So this is the way. When you get the remainder, that is 10, then you have to represent over there 10. Okay, let's suppose you get the remainder over here 10. So at this time, you are not supposed to use 10, you are supposed to use A. Okay, when you get the remainder 15, at that time, you are not supposed to use that 15, you have to use this F. This is the way. Okay, binary, octal, there is no difference. With 8, whatever value you will get, that would be automatically converted into the octal. If you've done this, this would be, you know, the literally one character change into this logic and this logic. And for hexadecimal, you have to implement this concept. Okay, take care this thing into the mind before implementing it. Now again, you have to check the number is palindrome or not. First, you are supposed to perform this assignment. Okay, assignment number 5, after 1, assignment number 5, then automatically this would be done, because this logic is 90%, this logic, you know, the same into all the assignment, whatever assignment that I give you, the all logic is same. Okay, so palindrome number, this time the number, not string. String you can easily check it out. this is palindrome or not, but this time I am talking about number, okay, talking about number 1 to 1. So how we will check it, this number is, you know, the palindrome or not. Now first, what is the palindrome? The palindrome mean, if I start from this, if I start from this, in the both of the cases the number is exactly same. Perfect, perfect. Now if it is string, if it is string, then we know it's very easy, very easy. What we will do, x colon colon minus 1. But this time this is the number, this is the integer entity, okay, this is the integer value. And if I perform the with integer the slicing, I will get the error message. So you have to implement some kind of logic. Now I am giving you the logic for the same, how we can find it out its number is palindrome. So for the palindrome, first we have to run from the back side. So I am giving you one hint, if any number divided by 10, okay, 10 ones the 10, you will get 21, okay, 10 to the 20, you will get 1. So I get the 1, previous number, the last number, any number, you can take any number, for example 1 2 3 4, you have to check this number is palindrome or not, okay, you have to check this number palindrome or not. Then what you have to do, simple, 1 2 3 4, 10 1 the 10, okay, now 10 to the 20, okay, now 34, 10 3 the 30, now you will get the previous number, okay, now you will get the previous number. You have to store this previous number somewhere. Now 4 you get. Now in the next iteration, what do you have to do? You have to get this, you have to hold this as well, okay. So how I can get this and how I can get this, I'm giving the hint for the same. When 1 2 3 double divided by 10, at that time you will get this quotient, that is 1 2 3, okay. When 1 2 3 modulation of 10, at that time you will get the remainder, that is the 4, okay. Now in the next iteration, what you have to do, you have to use this number 1 2 3. Again you have to 10 10 1, okay, then 32, okay, 2, yes, you get this, you get this, you get this 3, okay, and you get this 3. Now into the next number, into next iteration, what we will pick, we will pick this 12, okay, 12 1 the 10 1 the 10, you will get 2, okay, I got this 2, okay. Now into the next iteration, 1 divided by 10, okay, now this time when I do this, you know, this thing, okay, now remainder would be 0, and here here the quotient would be 1, okay. When I do this, I don't exactly, I think it's not right way to write this, okay, now the quotient would be 0, okay, 0.1 that we get, 0.1 that we will get, okay, the quotient is 0, this one, the quotient is 0 and the remainder is 1, okay, remainder is 1, okay. Now you get, go to this one, okay, when I get 0, at that time that I have to stop the entire process, that's mean I reach at the end of the point. Whatever large number is there, let's suppose the number is 1 2 3 4 5, the steps are same. Let's suppose the number is 1 2 3 4 5 6, the steps are same. Let's suppose the number is 7 8 9 3 2 1 4 3 2 3 3 3 3 5 5 8 8 9, the steps are same. We have to perform these steps until, okay, while the quotient doesn't become zero, okay, we have to perform until the quotient doesn't become zero. When this quotient becomes zero, immediately that while will be stopped out. And now you can observe it. Now you can observe it. Now you get this 10. Okay, you guess first time you get this 4. If I do this 4 into 10, then what will be happen? 42. Okay. In the next iteration, and I am adding this 3. Okay, I am adding this 3. Now what it become? 43. Okay, into the next iteration, what I did, 43 multiply by 10, okay, that's become 430, and I added 2, okay, now it's become 432. Into the next iteration, 432 multiply by 10, okay, I got 4320 plus 1. Now you can check, this is the mathematical way. Now this is the mathematical way to do the reverse of a number. Then what we have to perform into this scenario, first we have to use this sign, okay, we have to use this sign, okay, for addition that we have to this sign, for multiplication that we have to this multiplication, and until our condition would be while n is greater than 0, then until we have to perform this scenario, okay. If I writing this code, n is equal to, you know, 1 2 3, while n greater than 0, okay, then what you have to do, n is equal to n double divided by 10, okay, and next is equal to, I am taking over here, s is equal to 0, okay, and this time I am writing x is equal to n modulation of 10, okay, and inside s is equal to s plus your n into not your n x into 10, okay, and after completion of this I am printing this s. That's it. This is the way the problem that I sorted out for your reference. Now what is happening? Okay, now observe the scenario. 1, 2, 3 greater than 0. Okay, iteration number 1. I am writing over step over here 1. Now 1, 2, 3 greater than 0, perfectly greater than, condition is true, then we have to perform these steps. Now n is equal to n double divided by 10. Okay, when I use n double divided by 10, what output I will get? I will get this 12. Okay, now this time n become 12, perfect. Okay, now x will become 3, good. Now next step, s is 0 in starting 0, 0 plus, okay, 0 plus this x is 3 into 10. Now 0 plus 30, how much? 30. This is the iteration of 1. Okay, iteration of 2. Now n value 12, 12. Okay, 12 greater than 0, then what we have to do? We have to perform this. Okay, 12, 10, 1. Okay, now 2. Okay, in n 1, in x that is 2, in s that we already know, that is the previous value 30. Now if I perform this step number 2, here I got n is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, okay, s I know is 30. Now s is equal to s plus x into 10. Okay, now 30 plus, I think I did a mistake, 30 plus 20. No, I did some mistake. Okay, let me clear this mistake. Okay, this time what I have to do over here, sorry, what I have to do here, 10 multiply by 10, okay, sorry, 10 multiply by 10 plus your x. Okay, I'm doing from the start. Okay, now observe this scenario. Iteration number one, okay, when I run this, I got n is equal to 12, okay, and x is equal to this 3. Perfect. S is equal to 0, the starting value that I already defined, s is equal to 0. Now this is the iteration number 1. Now what I have to do? S is equal to s 0 into 10 plus your x become 3. Now what output I will get? 3. Perfect. In the one iteration. In the second iteration, what I have to do? Now observe this scenario. Where 13? 3. No. S multiply by 10, 0. 0 plus 3. 3. Okay, this one is 0 because in the first iteration that S is 0. Now S become 3. Okay, in the second iteration, we perform this. N become 12. Okay, N become 12. X become 2. Okay, X become 2. And now this one, S is equal to, okay, s multiply by 10 plus x. Now this time s value 3 multiply by 10 plus x value 2. How much? It's a 32. Okay, in the iteration number 3, now this time what value I have to use? N 1 greater than 0, condition is true. Now inside n becomes 0, inside x become 1. Okay, now perform this one. This time what x contain? 32. Okay, if I perform this, 32 multiply by 10 plus how much x contain? 1 plus 1. Okay, now this s become 3 to 1, exactly the reverse of this number, the 1, 2, 3, and we are getting 3 to 1. Okay, now n is 0. 0 greater than 0? No, the loop is breaked out. Now what you have to check? If this number, okay, prior to implement this step, you have to store this number into one variable. Let's suppose I am storing into a temporary variable is equal to n, because I am changing the n value. After processing this step, n becomes 0. I lost the previous value. So for that, I am storing this number into the temporary variable. After processing this entire steps, after processing this code, what I am doing? If temp double equals to s, that's mean you have to print palindrome, else number is not palindrome. This is the entire step that you have to perform this way. Okay, for this logic, you have to perform the entire steps. Okay, the entire step. These all problem statement are based on this step. So if you clear this step, automatically this assignment you are able to solve it. Okay, so try by your own. I give you the one reference for this. Okay, this one is the username and password. This is very basic assignment. You just create a basic one. I will create it into the production level. So what exactly happen? Okay, if your username is okay, then it will ask for the password. This is the first scenario. But you are supposed to perform the very simple. Whatever you think for this particular, you know, the application, you try to solve it. Whatever advantage, whatever, you know, the feature you want to impart, you can impart it. But I will make a basic application. Okay, after that I will convert it into the production level. Now what inside the production level? If your username is okay, then it will ask for the password. Okay, if you enter three time wrong password, then it will hang you into the system for 1 minute, okay, or for 24 hours, okay, or for 10 seconds. That choice is again your. Inside our mobiles, what exactly happen? If you try for the three times wrong password, then it will say come back after 5 minutes. Okay, again, what you are doing? After performing, you know, after coming back five times, you again enter two wrong entries, then it will say come back after 25 minutes, something like this. So I will create this thing, okay, this program problem into this particular specific in, you know, the requirement. So you are supposed to make this very simple one. I will make it into the professional level, but prior to make this program, you are supposed to perform all these, because these are the important one. These programs are the important one. The 7 to 8 programs are the important one, and this logic will be implemented into the all of the problems. So try to solve it. Okay, try to solve it, and you have Sunday. Okay, for this assignment, if you have any doubt, my videos are available into the US Data Technologies. And if you're having doubt for the prime numbers, okay, if you have anyone having the doubt of the prime number, I think there would be a video regarding prime number into the, I think the playlist is class 6th or playlist is a class 7th. My wife give the explanation, you know, for this standard 6th or might be into the 7th, what are the prime numbers. I will share also the link for the same. You guys can try for that. If you have any doubt regarding what are the prime numbers and how we can find out the number of prime or not. So for this assignment, whatever I explain, try to solve by your own. And you have again Sunday. Enjoy your Sunday with these assignments. If you have any doubt regarding these assignment, Sunday and half Monday. If you have any doubt regarding these assignment, then I will share you the link for the same in the US Data Technologies. There is the video number, I suppose, 21 or might be it's a 20. I explain in great detail what you have to do into these assignments. Okay, so any doubt for till now before closing this session? We already, I think the session become okay. No problem. Don't worry about it. If you done this, then very good. If you find any, you know, the difficulty, then I will cover it step by step. Don't worry about it. Okay. Sir, the syllabus we left. Nahi, we just complete, I think 10% or I think 20%. I think this is not, I think 20%. It is approximately 15% or might be 16%. Not exactly 20%. inside while you can use by, no problem at all. Yes, yes, yes. N number of for loop you can impart, n number of while loops you can impart. That is totally depend upon the situation. What is your requirement basically? Okay, Mohammed sir, do you have any doubt? Okay, assign. will you submit the assignments or not? Okay, no problem. Try to solve them, and hope you will submit this time at least 2 or 3 assignments. And I would be happy if you at least submit 2 assignments. I would be more happy. So try, don't worry about it. If you done, very good. If you don't done, again, very good. I will solve all these assignments step by step. Okay. So thanks for attending this session. Thank you very much. Recording will be available within 2 hours. Okay, thank you.